Good afternoon, friends. This is the weekend wrap in English. This is for the date 10th of August 2020. You know, a lot of my English speaking friends and friends from the South are worried that why I am moving towards Hindi. See, I love all my followers, whether they are English speaking or Hindi speaking, they are all my countrymen. And my endeavor is to give them content in language they understand. So from here on, you know, whatever time and effort it takes, I will try to make content both in English and Hindi to the extent possible. Okay. So since this is the weekend and I can afford to do it, I am coming with a weekend wrap in English as well. Now, what we'll be studying here is the US charts of S&P 500. Just to see if there is any sort of weakness which is creeping out of global markets. Then we'll study the Nifty, Bank Nifty charts, sectors, Reliance, and a few interesting charts that I have seen over the week. So let's get started. Let me open up my investing.com charts. It appears that I have closed them down. So I will have to open them again. Please bear with me because by mistake I closed down. Okay, so we are going to look at the S&P 500 charts for the daily time frame. Now, as you can see here, it is very, very clear that while S&P 500 opened gap down through the day, it went up. Okay, even on the weekly chart, I had mentioned this level of about 3380, and we have closed at about 3351. So again, bullish candle, nothing wrong till now. See, even the S&P sometimes will show bigger momentum, sometimes shows less momentum. The idea of watching this is that till this is heading up, we will go up. Whether we go up in a volatile manner or whether we go up in a straight line manner, we will go up. So now let's start with the Nifty chart. This is the daily chart of the Nifty. Again, you can see that we are in a ranging context. As far as I am concerned, you know, if I have to see which bars are in this range, maximum of the bars should be contained when you are drawing a certain range. So according to me, the lower end of the range is about 11,050 and the upper end is 11,250. If somebody must take the entire range, then I would think 10,900 to about 11,300 could be that broader range for, but for the purposes of analysis, I would think that the market weakens below 11,050 and strengthens above 11,250. So nothing wrong here. What you want to do is that you are still in a ranging type of action. So if the market dips, say early morning or any time in the middle of the day, you want to buy into declines. If we watch the Nifty chart on the weekly basis, again, previous week was red, this week was green, and we took out most of the red. So clear indication we are heading up. See, I like to do simple analysis instead of trying into, you know, nitty gritty and, you know, indicator and what indicator is saying. Indicators in a sideways market say nothing, and in a trending market you don't need indicators. So if you look at the monthly chart, contained within last month's bar but still positive. Now on the pivot charts, we have a level for Monday. The pivot is 11206, but since we are in a sideways type of context, I would like to take 11160, which is S1, as my relevant level. On the weekly, I think the weekly pivot is about 11130. So any sort of dips towards these levels, 11130, 11160, they will give you a nice intraday type upside. If you want some kind of a stop on your swing position, that is 10,980, basically just above below 11,000. So that is the strategy for the week on Nifty. If you want some small targets, intraday targets, 11,270 and 11,314 are intraday targets. Now let's go to the Bank Nifty. Daily chart, we have been talking about the daily chart being quite weak. But even in a weak chart, sometimes the downside starts to get exhausted. I think given the way the market has acted on the credit policy, I think the Bank Nifty is getting ready for some sort of a pullback rally or a trading rally. I am not keen on participating in Bank Nifty, but some people can be. So that would be your outlook on a weekly Bank Nifty chart. So far, you know, still 21,000, 23,000. So you will see more action within this range. and 21,000 remains your line in the sand where you give up all your bullish hopes. Okay, so you have this range to trade 21,000, 23,000. I would think the rallies may not be able to get to 23,000, somewhere in the region of 22,300, 22,400. The rallies may just get petered out. On monthly action is quite poor. Last month, you know, you had a negative candle. You have a small bullish candle this month, but you know, some kind of a pullback rally still seems to be on here. Okay. Now, having said all of this, you now want to look at the Reliance chart. Reliance daily chart you had this big green bar, then you had these small red bars, and on Friday you added this little green bar. Now this is the big momentum push. This is the kind of corrections you are getting. So the market will break out if Reliance comes out of this range and goes up sharply. Very narrow range on Friday. It's quite likely in the next week you should have a breakout. Weekly on Reliance, the bears came and tried to push the Reliance stock down. Unsuccessful. Most of this red bar has been taken out. I am very hopeful that you take out 2200 next week and you move on. See, I don't know if I have mentioned it in an English video. If a bar is green, the odds of the next bar being green are 80%. If a bar is red, the odds of next bar being red are 80%. So that is all the analysis you need with proper stops, etc., and that works. Okay, now let's have a look at some sectors. Nifty IT, again, big uptrend, narrow range, and you should finally have the Nifty IT move higher. Okay, there is no question of shorting anything. Let's have a look at couple of IT charts. Infosys, sideways at best. So it is just waiting for averages to catch up, which the averages are doing. TCS, again, sharp move, and the TCS stock is consolidating, which at some point, chances are, will break on the upside. Let's have a look at Nifty Pharma. The lesson from Nifty Pharma is that the deeper the bear market, the stronger the bull market post that. So all your frontline pharma stocks will continue to move up. I think if you see the weekly chart, you know, look at this bull run, which has started very, very strong. Chances are it will continue. Let's look at Nifty FMCG. Again, on a weekly basis, Nifty FMCG is very, very strong. And on a daily basis, you can see it's made some sort of rounding bottom and now coming out. Next week, Nifty FMCG could do very, very well. Plus, you have something like Muthoot Finance correcting back to between 20 and 50. Watch for an for a resumption of the uptrend. Gold remains in an uptrend. There is no question that Muthoot Finance at some point will move up. Nifty metal. Nifty metal index is moving up sharply. This is another one which is coming out of bear market. Weekly chart, big strong bullish candle. So my sense is that now Tata Steel, JSW Steel, etc. will move up strongly. So these are the kind of stocks that you have to be in. I am not mentioning HDFC Bank, Kotak, all the financials, because you just have to see the green which is appearing on these charts. This is Tata Steel. It has made some sort of a bottom and now is going to go towards this 470, 480 zone, 200 week moving average. Okay. So very, very important that you know you stay with the strong stocks. I guess that should be it for this week. Let's hope we are able to get out of the range we are stuck in next week. And the only problem point, if you ask me, is this, you know, dollar index. I think this is moving up because of delay in stimulus. Once the stimulus comes in, chances are that the dollar should decline again. But this is a little irritant that you will need to face in the next few sessions. That should be it. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial advisor if you take or if you act on any of these recommendations.